Lethal.
I'm sorry, Illegion.
I think the most thing, see how the community, if you ask the question, see how the community, they clear why a decision like that, and why is it happen like that. And then I think the most important is how, whatever the outcomes are good or not, I think it doesn't really matter. The most, I think the most important is, after the outcome, if the outcome's not good, how we can find out some another alternative way to, you know, to solve the problem. I think that's important, you know.
And do you identify that the problem is that the loss of war and that we don't feel supported as an artist?
What the first one? Second, I don't know.
The war, closing of war of the gallery, and then
I
think we need to be really clear on if we're going to go down this avenue, what do we believe they have failed at? We need to be clear on that.
Yeah, that's
okay.
Right. Yeah.
Yes, please. Yeah.
Okay, well, in my letter, I've written that primarily about how I feel about the loss of the gallery and what it has meant for me. Try to ask them or question them about. I feel that I feel really let down because a lot of the times in mental health organisations, well, throughout my life, I got acted upon instead of being in relationship with, and I was on the understanding that this place was about being in a relationship, and and that it was run from the bottom up, and it's been really beneficial for me and many, many artists here, and I think that needs to be pointed out, and I think that that a lot of their behaviour is quite dictatorial and from the top down, and we are being acted upon as if we haven't got the voice. And I think those are systemic problems, and they in themselves there needs to be a shift in thought and behaviour around that for there to be any fundamental change. And it's not just us, it's the tutors as well.
Yes.
I mean, they'll have a strategic plan in place. They are now doing the job of the directors. So this hasn't just affected us, it's affected the tutors it's affected the tutors and the tutors' livelihoods. And their fundamental means of living and passions, and that needs to be addressed. That needs to be addressed and expressed.
They.
All of us not being here earlier, but other things are very good. But I attended the meeting with Max and Celine. These guys did a great job representing the artists. That was probably one of the more positive meetings, if not the most positive.
plans and all of that stuff with them. But from what I could gather, this is my opinion of the situation. Celebs and Max are different, but my general analysis of the whole thing was that keeping the gallery open is not an option at this point in time. It's just not, it's not feasible. It can't be done unless someone else is going to magically appear out of nowhere and take over that responsibility. The committee cannot and should not be responsible for the livelihood of the gallery moving forward after the time is done. Because it seems, in my opinion, that the committee itself and the structure, the internal structure of how they are doing things from the top, at the top,
so
is the biggest challenge that they're facing. And,
no, what do you want?
I want the internet.
Outside of that one sole,
have you tried Firefox or Chrome?
That they should be and are actually obliged to, because they are in that. They have, that's their first responsibility before anything else. Their next responsibility.
Well, that's about the only thing I can think of. You could ask to see if the other computers are working,
because
the internet might be down.
They need to make sure their systems function and they have a solid committee with enough members. There are only two committee members at the meeting to represent the entire committee. So technically, it wasn't even a meeting.
No, because they didn't even have a quorum.
But
the minimum is four.
But be sympathetic to the two committee members that did attend and also to the entire committee, because they've inherited a shitty committee. And it is that, because otherwise, I'm not to say that individual members themselves are, because they're not. They're not
yeah, they're really not. I actually like some of them.
And
it's.
I'm just not finished, but you can have a word after. The best strategy in place right now is for the committee to focus on sorting itself out and then make sure that they focus their attention on securing the studio, one for themselves, two for for everyone really.
Yeah.
Artists, tutors, committee. No one
is
has
it not working?
The gallery is something that can be sacrificed temporarily or if need be long term.
Yeah.
But the studio is something that should not and can. If you love Pablos the way that you do, then realize that the studio is fundamental to you. Because without it, there's nothing for us here. And I'm sure you will agree. But in order to sustain the studio, they need to sort this. The committee, their responsibilities, us, they have too much to be focusing on to try and fix. And if you have more than one problem that you're trying to solve at any one time, how are you going to be able to focus your efforts and your energies on solving the main issue? So in my mind, it was the committee needs to sort out in house, and they're getting help from Richard at Arts Access. He's doing an excellent job there. The studio, anything beyond that, I don't have the confidence in the committee to be able to deliver. I'm just really trying to paint that picture of like the reality of that situation.
But I think the major issues about the saving the gallery.
No, that's not. And I won't say it right now. I'll just be straight, clear cut, not look around. Otherwise, it's just feelings, emotions, and all of that stuff, and none of that stuff matters. Because at the end of the day, no one can afford to run the gallery. The committee can't. No one has come along with any sort of philanthropist or funding or nothing. So unless you can show up and say that you have 60k to run the gallery now, right now, in this moment.
But think it's not, you know, I think it's not the how much money you
pay. Well, it is. There's no one to pay for it. And when it comes to the end of its time, the committee and Pablos cannot afford to run the gallery. That's it. End of story. There is no maybe, whatever. There's no money.
Yeah, no, but the thing is, it's not about how they end up, you know, normally to run out the not only the gallery. It's about the long term and how they get the money to be made it open. That's
yes.
why that's what I was talking today, you know. That's the most important.
You were bang on right, and it's about how they do all of that sort of stuff behind the scenes. So that is why the committee should be focusing efforts
yes.
on
that's
sorting
also another point as well.
Sorting themselves out and their structure and all of that, because if they don't get that right, the tutors, you guys, the studio will not be a thing.
Yes,
they quite openly and honestly said if they can't sort it out behind the scenes, Pablos may not exist this time next year. I'm not trying to say fearmonger, I'm just this is what
you mean the
saying.
Yeah,
because finances.
That's why I was.
What I'm trying to say is don't get upset about it and don't be afraid, because at the end of the day, that's not your guys' responsibility. That is the committee's problem to worry about. The artist representative group is really good because you have a voice and you're doing everything right by having these guys go. And the fact that they went and they presented very well on your behalf.
Mm.
Understand that. These guys took the time to go. And they listen and they got all the information, they come back to that and they get to present it to you guys. So be really supportive of this guy. I do have to go, but I just want to leave that with you.
I'd just like to read under section 12 that Pablo's artists will have an opportunity prior to any final determination being made by the management committee to consider A. Service planning, B. Strategic planning, C. policy development, and the service quality evaluation. So, we actually do have some sort of pipeline feedback to the committee on those
yeah.
points
Alex.
As to whether or not they actually take any of that
You know, I still don't understand, you know, if Vincent can survive, Why paper that can't be survived?
Because
it's
getting help from Arts Access out to the world to help sort their shit out, basically.
So Johnson's had financial problems similar to ours some years ago.
Yes.
And what they did is they just pulled out all the stops and they tried everything to fundraise. They did this, that. They
yes.
worked their asses off.
Yes.
And Glenn, so like here, was, you know, spearheaded a massive campaign, which is exactly what we are about to do.
95% of her time is literally sitting in her office writing funding applications.
Yes,
so
what
I'm saying is there's a fundraising afternoon is in the planning where artists, staff and committee can come and we're all going to sit down together and brainstorm all the fundraising ideas that we could possibly do. And that has been talked about for about a few weeks already by the committee, and what they just want us all to have a coordinated plan so we're all knocking on the doors with the same story. So we haven't got one person over here going to someone saying one thing, someone else going over here saying that. So they are taking positive steps, you know, to try and pull us out of this. The studio is fine, it's not, but there are
But also, like, they have dedicated a team that sacrificed their time to go and do all of that work that Joe just talked about. So, you have to understand. Limited capacity here, like, unless you are actually going to be putting your hand up to volunteer to do the work, I think it's unfair to be so
do these things, and the committee members themselves are out. And there is no excuse. You are right. You can be as critical as to the council, right? But it doesn't get anyone anywhere. You know, like it is about identifying what the problems are, trying to find solutions, and then also being supportive and positive about it. Because the comment period that keeps coming back is, oh, okay, but why and how, and it's just going around in a circle. That doesn't
really
get anywhere.
Fabulous.